Hello friends, welcome to IAS 365. Today is February 17th, 2019 and I am here to present this course, that is the top 5 MCQs of the day. So subscribe to this channel and then click on the bell icon to get regular updates of all the videos. And this course is presented by me, Sai Ishwareshwant. You can follow me on my Unacademy profile also by searching for my name, Sai Ishwareshwant. So download the Unacademy learning app and search for my name and then you can click on this follow button and from here you can follow me. So on the platform I am teaching these courses, that is the Hindu for prelims and the top 5 MCQs of the day. So the top 5 MCQs of the day that I am presenting on the YouTube channel are completely different from these 5 questions. So if you are regularly following these 2 videos, then you will be solving 10 questions daily. So make use of these initiatives, these will be very helpful for you in the prelims examination. So let us start with the questions now. Before starting with the questions, I request you to please pause the video as soon as the question appears. And also try to answer each and every MCQ. And then don't forget to mention what is your score out of 5 in the comment section. So let us start with the first question. Consider the following statements regarding Sheri Samriddhi Utsav, a very important one. Sheri Samriddhi Utsav, let us see the statements. Through this, SHG members across cities are being linked to national government schemes. Yes, this is a very correct statement and that is the reason this particular scheme becomes very important, because it is linking all the SHG members across various cities with the government scheme, so that they will be able to know what are the government schemes and through which government scheme they will be able to take help, etc. So it is important one, Sheri Samriddhi Utsav. And what is the second statement? It is an initiative of the Ministry of Rural Development. No, this is wrong statement. It is by the Housing and Urban Affairs Ministry. So because it is mostly relating to the PM Awas Yojana, etc., like the housing schemes, and that is the reason it comes under the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So the first is correct and second is wrong. Hence here the correct answer here will be A, that is one only. Let us see the explanation. So the Sheri Samriddhi Utsav is an initiative by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, and the main aim of this particular initiative is to extend the outreach of Deen Dayal Antyodaya Mission National Urban Livelihood Mission, so it is a very important one, DAY, NULM, to the most vulnerable, and to showcase its initiatives and facilitate access to the self-help group members to the other government schemes. So that is the main objective, or you can say the main aim of this particular Sheri Samriddhi Utsav, and it is by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, Government of India. So through this particular initiative, SHG members across cities are being linked to the national government schemes like the Swachh Bharat Mission Urban and Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban and the Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, etc. So basically the SHG members are being linked to the national government schemes under this initiative, which is called as the Sheri Samriddhi Utsav, and it is coming under the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So let us move on to the next question, that is question number 2. Pahari Dam is located in which of the following states of India? So recently Prime Minister Narendra Modi has initiated this particular Pahari Dam. So it is located in which of the following states of India? Whether it is West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh or Arunachal Pradesh. So the correct answer here is C, that is Uttar Pradesh. And it is located on the Dhansari River. So let us see the next explanation. Pahari Dam modernization project was recently inaugurated by PM Narendra Modi ji. And Pahari Dam is a water storage dam situated on the Dhansan River in the Jhansi district in the state of Uttar Pradesh. So it is relating to the state of Uttar Pradesh. So this Dhansan River is a right bank tributary of the Betwa River, which originates in Madhya Pradesh. You should remember this particular point also. Dhansan River is a right bank tributary to the Betwa River. So you can see this, the Ken River and also the Betwa River here. So this is Betwa River and it is Ken. There is a controversy going on by the linking of this Ken Betwa interlinking project. So it is the right bank tributary of the Betwa River, and this Pahari Dam is located on the Dhansan River, which is located in UP, that is Uttar Pradesh. Let us see the next question, question number 3. Consider the following statements regarding Lattice portal. So recently it was launched. Let us see the statements. It was launched by the Inland Waterways Authority of India. Yes, this is an absolutely correct statement. And this Lattice portal is an initiative by the Inland Waterways Authority of India, that is IWAI. So the first statement is correct here. And what is the second statement? The only drawback of this Lattice portal is that it cannot facilitate the day-to-day operations of inland vessels plying on the national waterways. No, this is a wrong statement, because the main aim of the establishment of this particular initiative, that is called as Ladis Portal, is in order to facilitate the day-to-day operations of the inland vessels. So the main aim is this for this particular one. So the second statement is wrong here. Hence the correct answer here will be A, that is one only. Let us see the explanation. The Inland Waterways Authority of India has launched a new portal, that is called as the Ladis Portal, Least Available Depth Information System. You should remember the full form also. It is Least Available Depth Information System. So this particular portal will ensure that the real-time data on least available depths is disseminated for ship or barge and cargo owners, so that they can undertake transportation on the national waterways in a more planned way. So this particular thing is very helpful for the cargo owners and also the ship owners, because they will be able to find out what is the least available depth in that particular ocean or the sea, so that they can plan the movement of the cargo, ships, etc. So this Inland Waterways Authority of India has designed Ladis Portal to facilitate the day-to-day operations of the inland vessels plying on the national waterways, and also to avoid any hindrance in services and operations. So this is the main aim of this particular Ladis Portal, and it will be also reducing the hindrance, that is nothing but the problems in service and the operations. So here you can see the Inland Waterways Authority of India. Let us see the next question, that is question number 4. Consider the following statements regarding Deen Dayal Disabled Rehabilitation Scheme. One more important scheme regarding the disabled persons. So it is called as the Deen Dayal Disabled Rehabilitation Scheme. Let us see the statements. It is aimed to promote voluntary action of the people for the persons with any disabilities. Yes, this is an absolutely correct statement. The main aim of this particular Deen Dayal Disabled Rehabilitation Scheme is to promote the voluntary action of various people coming from various walks of life for the persons with disabilities. So for the first statement is correct here. And what is the second statement? It is organized by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. No, this is a wrong statement. Though this is disabled, it is not by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Rather, it is by the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So you should remember various schemes and various ministries that are associated with that particular schemes, because it is a very important topic. UPSC may confuse you with by changing the ministries. So the first is correct and second is wrong here. Hence the correct answer here will be A, that is one only. Let us see the explanation. For the overall empowerment of the persons with disabilities, a regional conference on Deen Dayal Disabled Rehabilitation Scheme is being organized by the Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities. This comes under the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. So that is the reason the Deen Dayal Disabled Rehabilitation Scheme comes under the Social Justice and Empowerment Ministry. So the main aim objective of these particular regional conferences is to create an enabling environment to ensure equal opportunities, equity, social justice and empowerment of the persons with disabilities. So in order to create equal opportunities for the persons with disabilities to the normal human beings, it will be promoted. So to encourage voluntary action for ensuring effective implementation of the Persons with Disabilities Act of 1995. So in order to promote voluntary action of various people and implement the People with Disabilities Act of 1995, is the one of the objectives of this particular conference, or you can say the scheme. So it is by the Department of Social Justice and Empowerment, and the ministry is the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. Let's see the next question, that is the fifth and final question for the day. Which of the following has organized the first of its kind 2-day workshop on Committee of Creditors and Institution of Public Faith? So there is a workshop which was conducted by one of these following organizations, and this particular workshop is based on the theme of Committee of Creditors and Institution of Public Faith. So whether it is by IRDAI or it is by NSE, that is National Stock Exchange, or it is by SEBI, Security and Exchange Board of India, or it is the IBBI, that is Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. So the correct answer here is D. That is, this particular initiative, which is called as Committee of Creditors and Institution of Public Faith, is from the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. So let us see the explanation. The Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, jointly with the State Bank of India and the Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs, organized a two-day workshop. What is the workshop? It is nothing but the name Committee of Creditors, an institution of public faith. And this workshop was unique and the first of its kind for the benefit of financial creditors, who comprises Committee of Creditors under the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code of 2016. So just remember that this particular workshop is by the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India. So this particular Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code of 2016 is very important one. Please read this type of acts also. It is by the Parliament of India and it is functioning very well. So that is the reason it is a very important one. Thank you for watching this video, friends. Subscribe to IAS 365 channel and don't forget to share this video to your friends so that they will also learn and answer these MCQs. So thank you for watching this video. Thanks a lot.